Just woke up. It's 8:30 in the morning. This is day one of the meditation. Here's the view. Currently a rainy day.
Hi everyone and welcome to the second video on my YouTube channel. The focus of today's video is meditation, and for this week I decided to implement 10 minutes of unguided meditation at the start of my day. As you guys may have heard in the first video, my two goals in life are to become extremely financially successful and to become a high-achieving physiotherapist who works for a professional sports team. So when I was reflecting back on how I want to achieve these goals and how I can achieve these goals, it really just came down to I need to increase the amount of time that I dedicate to working towards those goals on a daily basis, which in other words is I need to increase my productivity. So when thinking back on how can I increase my productivity, there's really two ways you can increase your productivity. One is you can increase the amount of time that you're working in a day. So if you worked 2 hours yesterday on X, Y, and Z, today you can increase your productivity by working 4 hours towards your goals. The other way is to increase or improve the efficiency of that time. So if you're working for 2 hours, you're working smarter. You're more focused for those 2 hours, and so you get more done in those 2 hours. Today I'm going to be focusing on the first aspect that I talked about, which is increasing the amount of time that I'm working on my goals. And the main way that I'm going to do that, or the main way I'm going to approach doing that, is by making it easier to work on my goals. And what that comes down to is essentially increasing my baseline dopamine levels. What dopamine is, or the function of dopamine, is it's the desire hormone. It's what drives you to take action. And so if I can increase my baseline dopamine levels throughout the day, doing more boring tasks and more unstimulating tasks, tasks that require sacrifice and that are delaying gratification for a later day, those tasks will become easier. And so just thinking about how can I increase my baseline dopamine levels, something that Andrew Huberman talks about is that just like when you take part in pleasurable activities like video games, eating junk food, watching porn, that spikes your dopamine for a short period of time. But after, your dopamine crashes and it goes below baseline. So let's say you started your day at 50. That number has no value or units. But just for the sake of the analogy, you start your day at 50 levels of dopamine. You play video games for an hour. Your dopamine's up to 100. After that, it'll crash down to 30. And you'll be at that for a couple hours. And doing that on a daily basis will eventually lower your dopamine levels, your baseline dopamine levels. The inverse of that is by doing painful activities or activities which are delaying gratification, which require sacrifice, which require effort, such as working out, such as going for a run, meditating, reading a book. Those types of activities, you'll increase a slight decrease in dopamine at the start, but just like how you crash when doing pleasurable activities, your dopamine actually spikes above baseline and you remain at that for a couple hours. And if you repeat these activities on a daily basis for a long period of time, your baseline dopamine levels will increase. So for today's video, I decided to take part in meditation, and just from anecdotal evidence from this past week, the first 2 days, the meditation, I wouldn't say it was hard, but it was definitely, I felt maybe a bit agitated at times while meditating. I wanted, you know, some stimulation. I found myself thinking about the time, so thinking about how much time has passed, how much time is left, versus actually just being at peace with myself and enjoying that time away from stimulation. However, towards the end of the week, I noticed myself being able to relax during those 10 minutes, not think about the time, and I just found the time passing by. And then the effects that I found later throughout the day were, it was just way easier to complete harder tasks or engage in harder tasks, whether that was reading a book or doing some schoolwork, which are inherently boring activities that most people won't see a spike in their dopamine. And then the second benefit to meditating in the morning was I just found it set the tone for my day, or I should say it set the correct tone for my day. Just starting your day with an activity which is directly focused on achieving your goals will put you in that mindset of working towards those goals. So I just found myself later throughout the day thinking about how I wanted to do more things that will allow me to reach my goals. So I would maybe pick up a book on, you know, self-improvement and just read for 15 minutes because I was already in that mindset. And so the overall conclusion from this video is I found the 10-minute meditation at the start of my day extremely helpful. I'm going to continue doing it. And although I covered on a few of the benefits of meditation, there are a lot more benefits. I'm not an expert in this field, so I'm not going to cover those benefits. These were the ones that I resonated most with, and I felt that they applied most to my life. So I thought I would expand on them. And I definitely suggest that whoever is listening to this video, go and try it for yourself. If you feel that it's made you more productive, or if you feel that it's benefited you in any way, you can then make that decision to keep implementing the 10 minutes or however much time of meditation in your day. And yeah, so I look forward to seeing you guys in my next video. Thank you guys for listening.